Another answer is nuclear power, which is much less controversial in China because of its prodigious demand for electricity and the inability of its people to mount any real challenges to the government's plans. Mainland China currently has 31 nuclear power reactors in operation and another 24 under construction. Compare this to the United States, which has 99 commercial reactors overall, supplying about 20% of its electricity needs. However, the US currently has plans to build just 5 more reactors, as it's instead choosing to embrace natural gas, wind, and solar power. Even France, who leads the world by generating 3/4 of its electricity from nuclear, is moving away from the technology, and will likely close nearly half its nuclear power plants in the next decade. The Fukushima accident in Japan, after the devastating earthquake there, also accelerated the world's breakup with nuclear power, even causing China to briefly suspend new projects. But while the rest of the world turns its back on nuclear energy, China is doing the opposite, more than quadrupling its nuclear capacity by 2030. The marquee project is the Haiyang Nuclear Power Plant in Shandong Province, which will eventually house 8 AP1000 Westinghouse pressurized water reactors, for a total capacity of 8,800 megawatts. 4 times more power than is generated by the Hoover Dam, a power station that provides electricity for 8 million people in the American Southwest. And when you factor in that the average home in China uses a fraction of what an American home uses, the Haiyang plant will end up producing enough electricity for tens of millions of people. But the $13 billion project is only the most powerful of the 13 different nuclear power plants currently under construction across China, 9 of which will have a maximum capacity of more than 6,000 megawatts. Most are near large cities, where power is needed most, but this strategy raises concerns that if there were an accident, tens of millions of residents could be exposed to dangerous radiation. The neighboring Guangdong and Lingao nuclear power plants have 28 million people within a 75-kilometer radius, including Hong Kong. That's many more than the 8 million who live within 75 kilometers of the San Onofre nuclear generation station in Southern California. But the decision was taken in 2013 to shut the California plant down, after numerous safety concerns became known to the public, highlighting the opposite directions the two nations are heading in when it comes to nuclear power. The other issue China must deal with is how to dispose of the many tons of radioactive waste it will be generating, which is always a contentious issue because no one wants that in their backyard. The current plan is for construction to commence in 2041 on a high-level waste repository site in the Gobi Desert. On the whole, the danger of a costly nuclear accident that China would pay for in both blood and treasure is fairly significant, but Beijing is apparently willing to live with that risk, judging by its unrestricted embrace of nuclear power. But these are tough choices, and it's important to keep in mind that in the age of climate change and ecological interconnectivity, nuclear power is still an infinitely cleaner alternative to burning coal. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, hit that like button to help it spread. Until next time, for TDC, I'm Bryce Plank, and as usual, thanks for watching.